working on the more distant sunflowers now, so I've pulled in a little bit closer. What I'm going to do is start adding some of the little, the stalks to the, that are holding the flower heads up. And yeah, I guess I'll use my mall stick. Sometimes I brace against the canvas, but again, this hooks over the top of my easel. And it allows me to steady my hands as I'm working. This takes a lot of the strain off of your shoulder. If you try, I could do it without using the mall stick, but it really puts a strain on your rotator cuff. And over time, when you're painting 6-7 hours a day, that really takes its toll. So I'm using just a mixture again of some of my phthalo blue plus white and some of my phthalo blue plus cadmium orange plus white. Just starting to add little stems in here. I'm using a very fine brush. This is called a fine liner brush, and it can make a very, very thin line. It's actually a sign painting brush, but it's really good for making fine lines. And these don't have to be real distinct, but you want some in there just to give that feeling of the sunflower stalk, so the heads aren't just floating above the background back there. This is impressionistically, but we just don't want those, we want them to feel like they are attached to plants. Here. I just kind of, wherever my color is, I bring a little stalk in. Just grounds those flowers. And then into my darker, I bring some of the lighter color down too. And this is very faint. This is in the background. I don't want this to be real distinct, but I just want it to be there. That one got a little brighter than I want it to be, but I can just come back and with a little bit darker color, go over that. This is just, we want the impression of the stalks back there, but they don't have to be real distinct, don't have to be real detailed. And then moving forward, I just come forward more with more in here. I can start back a little bit. And some are getting a little more distinct as we get closer. But right now I'm just concerned about the flowers in the distance. We'll work on the foreground ones in another session. Now I'm going to start adding a few little petals as they come forward. Just as, again, adding that detail will just bring them forward. Now this again is my mix of cadmium yellow medium plus mud plus a little white. And I'm just bracing my hand against the edge of the canvas here. Start adding a few little petals. As we come closer, we'll start seeing some petals. And now I need to work a little bit more on that center so it's in my flower. You can see how we start. As I move forward, I start getting a little more detail on my flowers. This is a mixture with a little bit more white in it. So I want to have the light hitting back in here. So as we come forward, I start adding the petals on the flowers. And not everyone, it's just I'm, again, this is pretty far away from us, so we don't want everyone highlighted, but. Just start giving some detail in here. The detail will help give the impression that this is coming forward, that's closer to us. Less detail goes far away, drops back, more detail brings your eye forward. We're painting on a two-dimensional surface, the canvas, trying to make it appear three dimensions. So there's certain techniques that we have to use to give that feeling. And more detail as we come closer to the foreground, adding more detail makes that appear to come forward. Now I'm going to make that center a little bit larger. That one's not big enough. You can see how this is starting to come. This is bringing some of these flowers, starting to make them feel like they're coming forward. Light hitting on there. By using several different combinations of greens and the yellows, that gives a lot of variety. You don't want everything just to be the same yellow, the same green. So you have to go back and forth. And I keep washing my brush out and wiping it to keep my color clean. I use a lot of tissue. That's just regular bathroom tissue. It's the cheapest that we can get. Jack would say it's not fit for human use, but it is perfect for wiping your brushes. Now I'm adding some little darker yellows in there. Now I'll go back here a little bit further and add a little light. It's working back and forth. Sun's going to hit these flowers differently, so some back here will be a little bit lighter, some will be darker. I'm going to bring a little green in there around those to help shape them. I'm going to keep my brush clean so that my yellows stay nice and crisp. Center into this one. I'm going to wait on these in here because they're getting bigger, so I'm going to do those in another session. But this is how you just kind of go back. You just see places I want to add some hot light. And these back here are just very, done very loosely, not tight, not real detailed, because you just want them to go back. I add the yellow, then I can come back in and add centers on ones that I need to. That one needs a center. That needs one. Get that a little more petals. We'll add some light back in here. center. Make that a little bit darker. But again, you can see I'm applying quite a bit of texture, and I just gently lay the paint on top of the green so it doesn't pick up that color underneath. You have to be very, very gentle. Okay, I'm going to put those centers in. Add a few more little stems. And there's our distant sunflowers. Thank you for watching. I'm going to add a few, I just saw a few little places. I want to add some leaves in here. Because we're starting to get where we'll see the leaves. This will be bluer over here because this side I want to go back more. Bluer leaves in there. I'm going to have some little lighter ones here where the sun's really popping in here. All right. I think that gets us on our distant flowers. These are little blue, and there we go. Thank you for watching my YouTube videos. Please subscribe to my channel and also visit my blog where I show the step-by-step process, the entire step-by-step process of my paintings. You have a great day, and thank you again for visiting the studio.